Hi, I'm Heather, one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. Today we're going to talk about the sensor factory sensor. Besides that being a mouthful to say, I'm going to tell you what that is a little bit. The sensor factory sensor takes channels from multiple sensors and puts them together into one sensor. Also, you can create an extra channel with summarization or calculations in the sensor. I'm going to give you an example so this makes a little bit more sense to you. If you want to have a sensor called email service, so it would have all the various different devices and components in your email environment in one sensor, so if any of those components went down, then you would know you would either have a warning or a down problem with email in one sensor. I'm going to walk you through how to make a sensor factory sensor now. All right, let's now go inside PRTG and we're going to look at the sensor factory sensor. We're actually going to create one. But to do so, we got to go through a few steps to get there. So first of all, when you do create a sensor factory sensor, you could do it on an existing device or a different device. Sometimes, because the sensor factory sensor is being made of multiple channels, which could come from different sensors or different devices, you may just want to create a new device. So what I'm going to do is create a dummy device. So I'm going to go to my power group here and add a device. And I'm going to just call it sensor factory device. To go select power. Okay. And we will call this sensor factory device just because it's an example. And because it's a dummy device and it's not really pointing to an actual physical device, I'm going to just use zeros for my IP address and say OK. And you'll see my new device is here. So what am I going to do for this example? Well, if I go over here for this device, I'm going to see here I have voltage meter B and voltage meter A. So what I want to do for this particular sensor is list these two channels for the voltage for power consumption, and then I'm going to create a third channel with summing these two together, because with the sensor factory sensor, we could put a mathematical equation in it as well for an extra channel. So that's why we like the sensor. So you can see where I'm going to get them from. So to add the sensor factory sensor, we're going to say add sensor like you would for any other sensor. You could go through this nice long list, or you could select custom sensors here, or you could do my favorite way of saying sensor factory. And you can search and it comes up. Any of those ways works. Here, we're going to just keep the sensor name as sensor factory, but you could put energy totals or whatever you'd like to describe it. So the part with the sensor factory that's the challenging part when we're going to walk through slowly is the channel definition, because we have to manually type in the channel definitions for it. If you go to this little button that says I up here, it actually our help menu, because PRTG is great like that. It will give you examples of what you need in here and tells you what the basic syntax for the channel definition looks like. All right, let me paste in my formula, and you can always make the window bigger by dragging down here also so you could see everything. So I put in my channel one, I'm calling it volts channel one, and you can see here I have a sensor ID with a comma and a zero. So let's go over here and let's take a look at that sensor ID. So I'm taking a look at voltage meter one is the first sensor I'm putting in my sensor factory sensor. And you can see here the sensor ID is 27691 is what I defined. And that comma zero that I have, that's because for this channel, the channel ID is zero for that sensor. So if I come back here to my sensor factory sensor, you're going to see the sensor ID comma zero. So my first channel is going to be this channel, and that value for this sensor channel is going to be the channel first one for my sensor factory sensor. The second line here, I have volts channel two with the second sensor ID is 27692 comma zero. So I will come back here and go to my voltage meter two. You're going to see 27692 for my sensor ID. And again, the volts channel ID for the sensor is 0, so that's what's going to be the second channel for my sensor factory sensor. The third one here is going to be a total. So this is where I'm actually making a channel out of something that does not exist in PRTG with a mathematical formula. So here I'm going to call this total because I want that channel to be the total of channel 1 and channel 2. So I put the sensor ID here, the sensor ID here, I do my plus sign here, and I make sure my parens work out for my mathematical formula, and that is where my third channel is going to come from. All right, let's say create. So the sensor creates. It's adding the sensor like it always does for a sensor. And then here I see my sensor factory sensor. Let's give it a scan now so it gathers the data. We go into the sensor factory. And then here you could see my volts for my channel 1, volts for channel 2, which is the data we did that. And then here for my total, you see did the mathematical calculation here for the sensor factory sensor. So I hope that this helped to clarify what the sensor factory sensor is. Always keep in mind, it does take a lot from the resources for PRTG for the sensor factory sensor. We don't recommend more than 50 of these per probe. If you do need to find that you do use a lot of them, I would suggest using more remote probes, scatter them out to help load balance it so you don't use up a lot of your resources for your PRTG server for that. So now just keep in mind, if one of these channels would go down or get paused, then the sensor factory sensor, those channels would show them in some state of alert. So let's go and give that a try. So if I'm going to come in here, if I am going to pause this, and we go back to our sensor factory sensor. You could see now that it is in warning because it's not collecting data. So that's also another way you can use sensor factory sensor to monitor a business process or something like that, because it is doing multiple channels from multiple devices in here. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it clarified the sensor factory sensor and you can use it to do creative things in the PRTG with it. If you have any questions, please email us at support@pessler.com. If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com. And always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.